I'll keep a close eye on him, ma'am.
God help me!
No two ways to it. Charming this county the Black Clad's granted Caldwell to rape.
Yes, a gift so lovely Caldwell could not refuse. Ep Dahi, it seems, wished to be rid of the Count, so as to rule Lyria alone.
I do wonder why they quarreled.
Caldwell wished to rule by Willem's hand, and by his claim. Of little benefit to Nilfgaard, so the General disapproved.
As do I, by all means.
Yes?
Hungry like a wolf, I am.
Help!
only lose corpses, except sometimes they're quite fresh.
Arm is a waste of time for one like me.
Help!
You mad? Don't shake that!
That bit the white of an eye from half a league away.
Left, right, left, right.
This could hurt.
Bigger they are, easier they are to touch.
Again and again and again.
I think you'll really like this one.
We must trust each other.
Who's this? Not sure what it is yet.
Coin never stinks, no matter how rank the pouch.
I live to serve you.
Oh!
Army's a waste of time for one like me.
For you, pal! Anything! Getting to work.
One man's battlefield is another man's ripe patch for harvest.
It's not too late to walk away. I'm pleased to see you again.
You wish to speak with me? In private?
Yes, ma'am. I've given thought to certain matters. The time's come to explain and reveal my decisions. I've not been entirely honest, but I've seen you very much deserve the truth. You're brave, wise, and above all, you've a good heart. And thus you're unlike any other ruler I've ever met.
Isabel, what is it you wish to say? You're starting to worry me.
I told you of Sintra and Sodden. Do you recall? It's true, I took part in that war. Yet I fought for the Empire.
What? I'm not certain I understand.
My name is Isbel Ep-Wirmos of Nilfgaard. I wish I could say I am from a conquered province. I wish I had that luxury. But no, I hail from the city of the Golden Towers itself.
My, I'd certainly not expected that. Please, tell me more.
I went straight from the academy to the army, as majors do in Nilfgaard. Yet I truly believed our aim to be to build a better world. With our help, the mages, the Emperor conquered realm after realm, right up to the Amal Mountains. Yet he was not sated, and turned his greedy eyes to the north. But the north stood and faced him. I'll never forget the bloodbath he wrought in Sintra. It was unspeakable.
He sought to intimidate us. He united us instead.
Indeed. At Sodden, when chaos engulfed the Imperial army, I saw my chance to flee the madness and begin life anew. And I did just that. I never sought thereafter to rejoin my countrymen or return to my home.
Instead, I stayed in the north and swore never again to use my magic to harm others. Yet I cannot stand idle as the Emperor perpetrates atrocity after atrocity. I wish to fight at your side.
All deserve a second chance. Yet from now on, there are to be no more secrets between us.
Certainly. I thank you. You've no idea what this means to me.
Good. Oh, and Isabel, this must stay between us alone, for your own sake.
I appreciate the concern, ma'am, but you needn't worry about me. I've lived for some time in the north, and dare say I know how to get by.
The city of the Golden Towers. Don't think I know any soul who's seen it with their own eyes.
Did you know many common folk believe they're made of real gold, the towers? Yet they're named for how the southern sun dances off their rooftops. My family lived in the capital long before Nilfgaard was ever an empire. The city is of great beauty, was always a source of pride, turned arrogance in time. When I was but a lass, my father would take me to the grand amphitheater to watch the gladiators fight. A daughter of Nilfgaard should grow accustomed to the sight of blood, he said. For to conquer the world was our destiny.
Dreadful. You must have hated it.
At the time, I saw nothing wrong in it. I admired the gladiators for their bravery, skill, finesse. Though now it shames me to admit it.
Duty calls. I must...
Of course.
As you command.
Sure for watches yet, but...
Thing about slings, they hide well.
An army's a waste of time for one like me. Left, right, left, right.
Feel any burning? See a local healer or wise woman.
Army's a waste of time for one like me.
Naturally. At once.
Suffering. For what?
Catch!
The chase is on!
I smell a leak. Yes? You should have been there.
Her Majesty knows what she's doing.
One man's battlefield is another man's ripe patch for harvest.
Ever have a storm knock out one of your teeth?
Left, right, left, right.
Yeah, yeah!
just when you thought things were about to get dull.
You can try to win them all, but you won't.
Oh, what a shame that it is that you were voiced.
Give me a time. Arbalista, your command. Armor won't say.
One bullet's all I need.
The Lyrians came to a crossroads. As Meave and her scouts conferred about the proper path to take, a footman, of a sudden, collapsed upon the muddy ground. His comrades strove to rouse him. Alas, to no avail.
What's with him? What's wrong?
The Queen asked, her eyes darting between the medic and his patient.
Typhus exanthematicus, Your Grace,
replied the physician, wiping his hands with a spirit-soaked cloth.
Typhus fever.
Contagious?
Extremely, I fear. Though not yet at this stage. The spots are but in his mouth for now. Tomorrow he'll be blotched all over. It's then the disease turns infectious.
I see. What about a cure?
The medic looked at Meave, shook his head and shrugged. Alas, there was precisely naught he could do. But where medicine fails, magic may at times stand in. Without giving it two thoughts, Meave called for Isbel.
It's typhus, I've no doubt.
The healer confirmed.
I know a spell that could be helpful. Weigel's cleansing, we call it. It takes time to prepare and many ingredients. Rather costly, or...
Coin's no object,
said Meave.
Get to work at once.
Isbel returned from the local herbalist with herbs valuable and rare. Fern blossoms, mandrake root, comfrey seeds, and more. She then pulled from her bundle a variety of vessels, funnels, retorts, alembics, carafes. Colored concoctions she then brewed, steam and strange odors rising from them. Hours later, after much effort, she had a few drops of a thick substance in a flask. Isbel whispered an incantation, then gave the remedy to the dying man. His tremors and fever subsided at once, the other symptoms fading within hours.
Yes? You can try to win them all, but you won't.
This could hurt.
One man's battlefield is another man's ripe patch for harvest.
Again and again and again. An army's a waste of time for one like me. Left, right. Again and again and again.
For you, pal! Anything!
Watch your heads!
An army's a waste of time for one like me.
Wait, you're serious?
Oh, be ashamed to have this beauty put to waste.
Company! Forward march!
Ever have a storm knock out one of your teeth? From half a league away.
What? Yes, I'm on it.
My pain serves a purpose. Guy Nettles, hungry like a wolf I am.
The chase is on!
I only need corpses, except sometimes they're quite fresh.
When will you ever learn?
I live to serve you.
It is a land of monsters. Belongs to them, it does. Beware, milady. No matter what they think, ye've a good heart, milady. It is a land of monsters. No matter.
For no visible reason, the Lyrian column came to a halt. Meave stood in her stirrups in a bid to see the cause. Something had blocked the way, it seemed. Something large. A tree felled by a storm, or an abandoned wagon. Neither was true. A boulder huge as a barn lay in their path. Footmen had slung ropes around it, planted their feet, and now sought to pull it aside. It did not budge an inch.
Perhaps I could assist you.
Meave turned in her saddle on hearing the voice.
Several travelers in faded robes warily crept from the trees. A young woman with long, light-colored hair led the way.
You don't much resemble a rock troll,
said the queen, eyeing the slender stranger skeptically.
But go on, do try.
The fair-haired lass crouched beside the stone, closed her eyes, and began to whisper. Horses tugged at their reins. A hound howled in the distance. And then, the boulder rolled to the side like an apple across the deck of a boat rocked by seas.
Who are you? Do tell.
A druid,
came her calm response.
This stone, it stood in our circle.
The woman silently turned toward the wood. Meave followed her gaze, and among the trees saw other large stones, cracked and scorched.
What happened here?
We refused the Nilfgaardians' aid,
answered the druid.
So they raised our shrines, though perhaps it's a blessing.
A blessing? How so?
A darkness fell upon Angren a time past, and it grows. The forest turns savage, its creatures drunk on blood. Folk have come to worship other cruel gods. It's time we abandoned this land forsaken and went south, to Khed Mirkvid.
Our path leads south too, though not as far,
said the queen.
Do join us. Given the times, there's safety in numbers.
The druids agreed and were grateful. They walked at the rear of the column, muttering prayers, their faces concealed beneath hoods.
It's war you want, then war you shall have.
one bolt.
We will never bow to the invader!
Babbit the white of an eye from half a league away.
Give me a time.
Bigger they are, easier they are to target.
Arbalist, at your command. I'm a wrong set.
Yes? I live to serve you.
Ah!
Got any victuals? Hungry like a wolf I am.
Left, right, left, right.
You can try to win them all, but you won't.
Can't take it anymore.
One man's battlefield is another man's ripe patch for harvest.
Bigger they are, easier they are to target.
Again and again and again.
When will you ever learn?
An army's waste of time for one like me.
Catch!
Left, right, left, right.
We'll catch them all! The chase is on!
Thing about slings, they hide well.
Again and again and again.
I only need corpses, except sometimes they're quite fresh.
Use this. Not sure for what just yet, but.
Company! Forward march!
Without hesitation.
I think you'll really like this one.
I smell a leak.
We shall achieve our goal.
Nothing personal, I assure you.
You sure about that?